I feel like they should have called this game The Bureau instead of XCOM The Bureau, because if you're coming into The Bureau expecting a traditional XCOM title like, for instance, XCOM Enemy Unknown, you're probably going to be disappointed. This game doesn't have that much in common with other XCOM titles. In fact, The Bureau XCOM Declassified has more in common with games like Dragon Age or Mass Effect. It's a third-person tactical shooter that if you come into it with an open mind, you're probably going to have a lot of fun. I'd go so far as to say the game is good, very good. Emphasis on good, not great, good. Now to break down what makes the game good is starting by the experience. Part of that is graphics. Graphically, the game looks great. The style, atmosphere, all of it are spot on. It's set in the early 60s, and the game is able to take you there and keep you there, which is difficult today with games for some reason. I don't know why. But the juxtaposition between the old and the new doesn't cause any problems. You see massive alien structures jutting out of the middle of 60s, 50s towns and high schools and supermarkets and stuff like that. But it still meshes together well. And thankfully, you'll be spending most of the game looking at these fantastically realized, richly detailed 1960s environments. They definitely don't feel like slapped together stock models that are, cut and pasted. They had thought put into them, and maybe even a little love. Unlike the alien environments, which you'll also be spending a large chunk of time within, which you could find in any mediocre game that has aliens in it. I mean, it's just rooms and quarters. It feels cut and pasted. It feels slapped together. It's almost devoid of any real detail. You could say that's the point, you know, to be cold and lifeless, kind of like the alien's lifestyle and thought process and actions, but that just doesn't do a whole lot in terms of improving your game experience, or immersing you in the game, for that matter. Something that does immerse you in the game, though, is the audio. You have a lot more than just a handful of voiced characters to stretch across the entire game. You have a lot of different voices for all these characters, and they're generally good voice actors and voice actresses.
We are at war, and not the one we were expecting. Groom range, 2100 hours. Survivors, 6.
Now, a few people out there may be complaining about the main character's voice.
Barnes, what the hell did I just nuke?
He does sound like a concrete going through garbage disposal.
Barnes, let's head home.
Should we sneak around him?
I don't sneak.
It's ridiculously guttural, but that's not his fault. I mean, he has a dark and a troubled past.
I can see we'll be fast friends, you and I.
How else would you know that, unless he had a deep, guttural voice? Well, he works alone and doesn't play by the rules. It's how you know your main character means business. I mean, they should have had Duke Nukem voice the commandos. It's time to kick ass and chew bubblegum, and you can tell by my voice.
Agent Nils, but good to see you alive.
The alien language, now they're on the subject of voices, is also done nicely. I actually am really bugged and bothered by some movies and video games, the alien voices. It's just silly, but it's pretty well done in this game, and maybe, kinda, if you're at night and you're alone, it can kinda be eerie, you know, the first time you hear it. But the music, is great. Complements the game perfectly. And it's unique, too. You don't hear too many tracks like these lately. And as countless others have said, the gameplay in The Bureau, XCOM Declassified, is far more along the lines of Mass Effect than the classic XCOM experience. So if that's all that you want from this title, if that's all you're after when you see XCOM, is just the XCOM experience, and you don't want to keep an open mind about what gameplay you might find in The Bureau, you should probably pass this up. It is definitely not like other XCOM games. But it is an enjoyable experience in and of itself. It's a third-person tactical shooter. It even has a unisprint cover button like Mass Effect. Mass Effect veterans will feel right at home with this title. In fact, that may be one of the reasons why I like this game so much. But even if you've never played anything like it, even if you've never played Mass Effect, and you like what you see, you like the gameplay that you see on screen, you're in for a treat because the gameplay is fun and it can get fairly involved, far more so than it could in Mass Effect. It is a third-person tactical shooter, and there's nothing more satisfying than calling a critical shot on the alien commander while your engineer lays down mines at their feet before setting down a turret at their flank while you lift it up so the turret can get a better shot down at the enemy aliens. And then you order your recon to call down a finishing orbital strike to mop up the remaining troops. That's a lot of fun. I had a lot of fun devising all kinds of little different strategies. That is definitely one of the better aspects of the game, maybe even the best aspect of the game. Naturally, you're gonna lose some of the finer tactical or strategical aspects when your genre is shifting like this, but I think they found a nice balance between real-time strategy and third-person shooting mechanics. Also, something to note, your squad doesn't seem to use their abilities on their own, so nothing gets wasted. Unless you screw up, which I did a lot, and that kinda sucked, but it's all up to you. Sure, your squad's gonna shoot at enemies, and you have all kinds of different backpacks to, for instance, give them more damage with their guns, or give them more damage with their abilities, or more damage in headshots, but basically, what's gonna kill the enemy is strategic planning with using their abilities, and they're not gonna use them on their own, so it's all up to you. I like that. There's a lot of different backpacks in the game, too. I mean, you got backpacks for headshots, you got backpacks that cool down your ability use, so you can use abilities faster, but it may limit your ability range, or you have a backpack that can increase your ability range, but decrease your weapon strength, a backpack that lets you stay alive longer when you're revived, etc., etc. Basically, these backpacks allow you to outfit your agents as best for the role that they're suited to be. For instance, I gave my engineer more range because I use his abilities a lot. I gave my sniper, I gave him a headshot backpack because he's supposed to headshot things. Aside from backpacks, you can also find really cool alien rocket launchers, lasers. Well, they're all lasers. SMGs, plasma pistols. The best one is the alien assault rifle, in my opinion. So there's a good variety of weapons in the game. You've got your human weapons and your alien weapons. You can carry two weapons. It can be two big weapons if you want to. You don't have to carry a sidearm if you'd rather not. I haven't gotten bored with the weapons in the game yet. It's a nice variety, and they've got a satisfying feel to them. Speaking of weapons, it'd probably be a good idea to talk about the enemies right now, the aliens. There isn't a great variety of them, but there doesn't need to be. There's the basic classes, which is light, medium, and heavy. You also have medium heavy, which are enemies with shields. Kind of like Mass Effect. Okay. But some of the enemies are pretty challenging. I like to consider them mini-bosses, although there aren't really bosses in the game per se. Yeah, there are. Never mind. But there's the mini-bosses, those are the heavy enemies, like the tripod walkers, or the mutants, as they're spelled. Then you got the little sectoid aliens, they're fun to headshot, pop in the head, they come open. Garrus's species in Mass Effect, they kind of look like them when they're in the armor, that is. They have nice designs, they're well-made, well-modeled, I should say. They're kind of challenging. In fact, they can get really challenging, especially if you're on the hardest difficulty. Oh, fuck, I forgot there's more. The base, the hub world. You've got a base in the Bureau, XCOM Declassified. Picture it as the Normandy from Mass Effect. It's your hub world, and you can talk to all kinds of different people, all kinds of little plot lines here. It's a lot of fun, but more importantly, you can direct agents onto missions. Now, you can't actually go on these missions yourself, but all the agents that you have in your roster, you can send them out on missions to do on their own. And by doing these missions, they can get new agents for you that go into your roster. You can unlock new items or weapons. There's also permadeath. I haven't seen it yet with my agents that I send out in the field, but they can die, I believe, that the agents that you send out on missions. So what I like to do, there's a limit. For instance, you need all agents to be an accumulative 10 skill points, you know? So instead of sending 2 5-level agents, I send 1 4-level and 2 5-levels. Because 4 and 5, well, that's 9. I gotta send one more guy. I'm not gonna send a level 1 guy, I'm gonna send a level 3 to 5 guy to make sure that everyone comes back alive. Now, with these missions, they increase, you know, their abilities, they gain skill points, quote-unquote, and they raise their ranks, they raise their levels, so you can swap them out with your current guys if you want to try a commando instead of an engineer, for example. The reason I mentioned the plot last is because, well, it's probably going to be the weakest point for most people. I can't divulge too many details because, oh, God, the spoilers! So I'm just going to put it at this, if you've played Mass Effect 2, Collectors. Very close to the Collectors. You play as a gruff CIA agent who don't take shit from nobody. And, well, he's got a drinking problem. He makes some friends. Some of his friends die. And then there's this big CIA agent guy that leads everyone. And there's a woman. She has a sniper rifle. You go all Independence Day, and, well, it's interesting. It's more interesting while you're playing it. It's not as memorable afterwards, but it's fun, it services the gameplay, and that's what matters. The best thing about this game is the gameplay, though. Do I recommend XCOM, the Bureau, to classify? Yes. I do. It's fun. I like fun. I don't use scales. I'm not going to give this... let's see, this is a 9.2 out of 5. No, it's fun. If you want to sit down for about 10, 13 hours and play a good game with good mechanics, that's kind of unique. You don't see many third-person tactical shooters today. And it's got a fun storyline. You know, why not? If only to give it a rental. I recommend it. Being a third-person tactical shooter, you'll be using cover a lot. But, unfortunately, cover is dicey. Sometimes you find a position that affords a broad overall view or perspective, perfect for mapping out your strategy and telling your agents where to go, what to do. And look! The blue shield is signaling to you that it's safe from enemy fire. Not that you need to be told, as you can plainly see by perspective that the enemies wouldn't be able to reach you with their guns, except it turns out that brick wall that you're going to use for cover affords less protection than a small car, and things stop making sense. You're being shot at. The wall seems to have another hitbox, maybe that of a shrub, because somehow the enemy is still hitting you. Using the cover mechanic, you make your bullet magnet dash behind another cover, but it's too late, because when an agent is out of cover, all the surrounding aliens get a memo and focus their fire on him. You go down, your character motions for one of your agents to revive you, but he's the recon agent, and you've neglected to outfit him with stealth capabilities, so he can't take the heat. He falls down while trying to revive you, but luckily, this gives enough of a distraction for your engineer to make his way to you. You're revived, but time has run out for your sniper, and that's how you lose an agent. I find it's better to just restart from the last checkpoint, because this game does have permadeath. That means that sniper's not coming back. That's why I find it's better to just restart from the last checkpoint, and then you're back to when he was alive. Because that mortality paperwork you have to fill out back at the base is a bitch.